Welcome back to the topic, Principles of Inheritance and Variation. In the last video, we discussed about chromosomal theory of inheritance and types of interaction, whereas in this video, we'll try to understand one example from interaction, that is incomplete dominance. What is incomplete dominance? It is an example for intragenic interaction. In incomplete dominance, both the genes of allelomorphic pair express themselves partially. That means what? As we know, always there will be cross between two types of gene. One is a dominant and the one is a recessive. In that, if both the genes are getting expressed partially, or say dominance gene is not able to express itself fully, then it is called incomplete dominance. As a result of this, one gene cannot suppress the expression of the other gene completely. That is, its dominant character will not get expressed completely, or it will not suppress the expression of the recessive character completely. As a result of this, intermediate expression will be produced. The condition where the dominant gene is not completely dominant and recessive gene is not completely recessive, they produce a product which is intermediate between either of the parents, is called as incomplete dominance. Let's try to understand this incomplete dominance by taking an example of 4 o'clock plant. The scientific name of the plant is Mirabilis jalapa. So, in the 4 o'clock plant, two pure varieties of the plants were observed. One was with red color. Red is dominant color of the 4 o'clock plant, which was producing red flower. So, the genotypes of the pure red, let it be capital R, capital R. It is crossed with another pure variety of the plant, which was producing white color of the flower, which is recessive. And the genotypes for recessive characters are small r, small r. Now, if there is a cross, F1 hybrid should be red according to the law of dominancy, that is, it will be with capital R and small r. But as you can see in the image, it was not red, it was pink. So, as you know, if you literally mix red color with the white color, you will get a pink. That means here the red is expressing itself partially, even white is also getting expressed itself partially. As a result of which, we get in F1 hybrid an intermediate offspring, that is with pink in color. Now, just for the curiosity, just to observe where the red and white color phenotypic expressions are gone, okay, F1 hybrid was allowed to self. That is, R, capital R, small r was crossed with the capital R, small r. Now, these are the gametes as capital R and small r. As you can see in the checkerboard, one is pure red with capital R, and another one is capital R, small r should be red, but it is become pink. And another one with capital R, small r also has become a pink. And the last one is white. So, F2 ratio will get 1 red, 2 pink and 1 white. So, both the phenotype and genotype ratios will be same. So, such a type of a variation where the dominancy is incomplete is called as incomplete dominance. So, we were able to see that in F1 all plants were producing pink flower, but in F2 the parental traits reappeared like red and white, that is pure varieties, making the ratio 1:2:1. Parental types were there in 25%, whereas the other character, intermediate character, appeared for 50%. So, that is a best example for incomplete dominance. If it is asked in the exam how to represent it graphically, let's try to understand. Flower color of Mirabilis jalapa and even snapdragon can be taken. Snapdragon is with the scientific name Antirrhinum majus. Okay, so here two pure varieties will be crossed, parental generation with the phenotype of red color and a white color. When they are crossed, the genotype is capital R for red and the small r for white. These two are crossed. When the cross is done, the gametes will be produced. The gametes are capital R and small r. When they undergo crossing, F1 generation, phenotype of the plants will be pink in color. Now, genotype of the pink colored plant is capital R and small r. So, when F1 was allowed for selfing, F1 produced gamete capital R and small r, thereby F1 undergoes a selfing. We have to put a punnet checker bow, and as you know, male gametes are written on the upper horizontal line, and adjacent side we are going to replicate the same gametes for the female. Then capital R with capital R has produced red, capital R with a small r has produced a pink, and small r has produced a white. So this is the graphical representation of the, that is, incomplete dominance. The phenotypic ratio is red, pink, white. The genotypic ratio is capital R is to capital R, small r is to small r, where the ratio both phenotype and genotype will be same, that is 1:2, 2:1. So this is a best example for deviation from the Mendelian genetics. Now let's try to understand another concept which can be asked for a 3 mark, that is explanation of the concept of dominance. So how the dominant characters get expressed? Every gene express itself by producing particular protein or an enzyme. Every gene, if it is a tall gene, it is going to produce a protein called as a tall protein and will make the phenotype expression as a tall. Okay, whereas this produced protein or enzyme which is there, that will be responsible for the expression of the particular trait. Now in the diploid organism like human being, we have 2 copies of each gene, correct? Now sometimes due to mutation, what happens, one of the gene undergo change. Say for example, if it is capital T, one of the capital T may undergo mutation and may get converted into small t. Now when there is a conversion of capital T into small t, capital T will produce a protein for tall character, whereas small t will not produce protein for tall, but it will produce character or enzyme for what? Dwarf character. So what happens, capital T protein is a normal, whereas a small t protein will be abnormal. So in such a case, when 2 genes come together as capital T and small t, the normal gene will behave dominant and the phenotype expression will become tall. So modified gene produces less efficient gene, a non-functional enzyme which is with no effect. During such condition, phenotype expression depends only on effect of normal gene which has not undergone mutation. So this can be asked for 5 marks. The gene which is getting expressed itself is called dominant, and the gene which has undergone mutation is called as a recessive. So in this video, we discussed one example from intragenic interaction, that is incomplete dominance, whereas in the next video we'll try to discuss another example from intragenic interaction, that is codominance. Thank you, students.